How's it going, everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can generate some random values in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. You can become a hero and save our channel by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro. Alright, welcome back ladies and gentlemen. In this video we're going to be generating some random values. Some random integers, doubles, and Boolean values. So if you're interested in game design at all, this video is a must for you. So in order to use random values, we should probably import the random class found within the library. So outside of the class, this is what we're going to type. We're going to import java.util.Random, semicolon. And now we have access to the random class, and that provides us a few options. We need an instance of the random class for us to use. Within the main method, we're going to create an instance of the random class by typing random with a capital R. It's the same name as the class, random. We need a name for this instance. Let's call it random, all lowercase, kind of like what we did with that video on scanners. Random equals new random. That's kind of random. Then a set of parentheses, then a semicolon. We now have access to this random instance to generate some random values for us. But there's a disclaimer here. These are not true random numbers, but something called pseudo-random numbers, which are pretty darn close. So I just wanted to give you that disclaimer before we got started, so you don't call me a liar. Let's generate a random integer and store this within an integer variable, like int x. Int x equals, and to generate a random integer, we're going to type the name of our random instance, random.nextInt. There's also a few others like NextBoolean, NextDouble, NextFloat. I'll get to those later. What we would like for now is NextInt. And then we will display the result with a println statement. We will display the value of x. So the results are on a scale between, I would say, just under negative 2 billion to just over positive 2 billion. So you'll probably want to limit that. Let's pretend that we're going to roll a six-sided dice. So to limit the scale or the size of the random number that we'll generate, we can pass in a value to our nextInt method. So within the parentheses of our nextInt method, we'll limit the size of the integer that's going to generate. If we would like a six-sided dice, we're going to place six here. But there's one catch with this though. This will generate a random number between 0 and 5 because computers always start with 0. And let's see if I can roll a 0. Nope. There we go. Alright, so one way to solve this is that if we want the numbers 1 through 6, we can just add 1. So now we'll get a random number between 1 and 6, just like that. This time, let's generate a random double value. For now, I'll turn this line into a comment. And let's create a new variable called double y. Double y equals random.next. Where is it? Double. And we will display the value of y. Next double is going to give us a random value between 0 and 1. So this probably has some uses for something. What that is, I'm not really sure. But hey, you know you can do this now. Let's also generate a random Boolean value. So Boolean z equals random.nextBoolean. And we will display the value of z. So this is going to give us either true or false. Well, everybody, that's how we can use the random class to generate some pseudo-random values for us. If you would like a copy of this code, I will post this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's a few uses of the random class. Also, be sure to leave a like, drop a random comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.